So if we look at the applications that are being discussed for 5G at the moment, we see many different types, first of all. Obviously, many of them are driven by the media sector. So we see content caching, rich media, augmented reality and virtual reality. These are the most popular ones. And the Pokemon developer, Niantic, developed a new game that utilizes edge computing. So, and 5G is supposed to bring that in the enterprise, in the campus application, and obviously outdoors. And we do see a little bit of complementary standards here. On one end, we see 3GPP in 5G releasing the user plane function, the UPF, and obviously distributing that at the edge of the network so that we have more flexible control and user plane decoupling. And that is the connectivity aspect. On the other hand, we see also ECI, MEC, multi-access computing, edge computing, offering the computational, the processing functionality. So we think combination of both will be needed, right? Because obviously you need the processing capabilities and the environment to create the application, but you also need robust connectivity and lower latency connectivity for these applications. So many applications we see at the moment utilize exactly that. So if we look at, for example, an application for automotive, right? So some level of self-driving cars or C-V2X that's being introduced at the moment. This utilizes both, obviously, robust connectivity from the edge to the device and also processing capabilities. And another point we need to consider is that AI will start to be deployed towards the edge of the network. And these AI models will obviously need processing capabilities for training and inference, but also they need reliable and low latency access to the cloud. So there will be training between the cloud and the edge. So we think overall that the future of 5G is in MEC, in edge computing, and that will need both processing and computing, but also reliable connectivity for both.